Hey everyone, welcome back. It's time for my first Q&A. A week ago, you guys sent me your questions. Today, it's time for some answers. I noticed most of the questions came on YouTube and Instagram, so I'm gonna stick to those two platforms and answer as many questions as I can. So here we go. First question from YouTube, it says, how many hours should one do practice per day? Honestly, depends. I mean, how many hours do you have? The more you do it, the better you get. So I would say put in as much as time as you can. Even for myself, there's days I practice for an hour, there's days I practice 2-3 hours, there's days I practice 8 hours. My days are a little different than yours, and it also depends where you are in your dancing level. Are you just starting out, or have you been dancing for a while? But again, like I said, the more you do it, the better you're gonna get. There's no specific time. There's nothing I could tell you specifically to do hourly. I would just say the more time you put in it, the better you're gonna get, the sooner you're gonna see the results. We have a question from Nikki underscore notes 87. She's asking, if you could go back in time, what advice would you give your younger self? I think the advice I would give my younger self is just to be patient. I think when I was younger, I wanted everything fast. And I see that a lot in people who are in the same age as I was back then. That usually comes in around 16, 17, 18, or when you finally realize what you want to do in life. And you just want all the results real quick. So I would just say be patient. Be patient, work hard, stay consistent. That's one thing I learned later in life. All the knowledge that I know now, I would tell to my younger self. Patience, consistency, work hard, dedication, just giving it your all to your passion. 24/7, nothing else, 100%. We have a question from Patterson Chaos. Sorry, I'm gonna try to pronounce as many of these names as I can, but he's asking, I found out about you studying the Hung Up routine in the Confessions Tour video. How did you get to work with Madonna and what was it like being on the road with her troupe? Thanks for sharing your work. It's funny, now that I do a lot of stuff on YouTube, a lot of the people that watch my videos don't even know anything about my past dance history, dancing for Madonna, dancing for Britney, touring, doing films, commercials, all of that good stuff. But I mean, as far as dancing for Madonna, I come from the professional dance world before creating dance videos on YouTube. I was touring and I was dancing professionally with artists, choreographing with artists, and going on tour. So the Madonna experience was, I auditioned for it just like any other dancer. It's one of my craziest memories as far as auditions go. I remember it was a 4 or 5 day audition. They had auditions in LA and in New York. They flew the best dancers from New York to come to LA and compete with the LA dancers. So it was definitely an unbelievable experience being on tour, traveling the world, touring with one of the biggest artists in the world, Madonna, working with her side by side, getting to learn from her, her team, Guy Oseri. I mean, it's indescribable. I think one of the things that I always tell people from that tour is the amount of stuff that I have learned creatively and business. I don't think any book or school or college would have taught me that. I learned all of that with experience and actually doing it. So amazing experience, and I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. We have a question from Samed2023. The question is, please dance on Indian songs. First of all, let me start off by saying I'm overwhelmed and amazed with all the love that I'm getting from India. Thanks for the support, thanks for the love, thanks for watching all the tutorials, thanks for all the comments, all the messages. It's amazing that I could create content and put it out on YouTube and people in India could watch it and learn and comment and write to me. So thanks for all the continuous support. As far as dancing to Indian songs, I already have. There's a link to one of the videos I've done in the description box. So if you wanna check that out, you can. And if you want me to dance to more Indian songs, send me more links in the comment box. I'll go ahead and listen to all the songs. If any of them inspire me, I promise I'll make another one. We have a question from Nikki Mirage. I'm just gonna act like that's totally fine and cool. So the question is, how to freestyle and dance confidently? This is a video I've been wanting to make, and I think by seeing this question, I must make this video. I've been wanting to create a video about freestyle and just breaking down the elements of freestyle and how all of that works. So I'll tell you what, I will make a video next week, put it out there for freestyle. So instead of answering this question, you will get a full tutorial on that question. Okay, so come back next week and you'll get a video on freestyle. We have a question from KP_Ta. The question is, what age did I start dancing? So I started dancing at the age of 7. I started taking it more seriously at the age of 13, is when I kind of decided that I wanted to be a professional dancer, and that was something that interests me a lot. I started taking more classes, being more active, dancing more, and then around age 15, 16 is when I got an agent, and then it kind of all just started from there, going to auditions and working professionally. So started dancing at 7, took it more seriously at 13, started dancing professionally at 15. We have a question from Son Goku. It says, in the movie Alvin and the Chipmunks, did you voice act on one of those squirrels? If you know anything about the Chipmunks, you know they have a specific voice, and I'm definitely not capable of making that voice. But what I did do, so I did all the dance moves for Theodore the Chipmunk. So any scenes that you see in Alvin and the Chipmunks, the sequel, dance moves wise, anything where they're dancing, moving, singing, those are the parts where I did, and then they animated and make it into a cartoon. Are you planning for an India tour? I'm not planning for an India tour at this specific moment, but I'm definitely interested in coming to India and possibly doing a workshop there next year. I appreciate the support from India. I love all the energy you guys are giving me, and hopefully that brings me out there next year. So if you're interested, hopefully I'll be there next year. All right, we have another question here on YouTube. It says, what's your ethnicity? I'm Armenian. I was born in Armenia, and then I moved to LA at the age of 7 with my family. From Ani Danilian, she's asking, what made you realize that dancing is your passion? Like I said, I've been dancing since I was 7, but at 13 is when I realized it was my passion. That was when I was watching a lot of music videos, a lot of performances on MTV. And it was just, wow, I was like, I could be part of that. I want to do something like that. So the minute I decided that that's something I wanted to do, that's all I did. From morning to night, all I cared about was dance. I slept dance, I ate dance, everything was dance. So once you start having that feeling, you know it's your passion, because that's literally all you think about. You start investing your time more into your passion, and you take away time from all the stuff that don't mean anything to you anymore. We have a question from Jalia Roxy. She's asking, how I could join your dance class, Miran, you inspire me. And what if I cover up your dance video every video? I'm guessing you're asking if you could do covers to my videos. That's more than fine. Will that be okay? Yes, it's more than fine. You're more than welcome to cover my videos. As far as joining my dance classes, my classes are in LA. If you're ever in Los Angeles, you're more than welcome to come to my classes. I would love to have you. Join us. You can see class information in the description box. All right, so we have another question from Instagram from DJ Bosmia. It says, sir, when you shoot your dance videos, you performance dance only one time, or it requires 2 or 3 takes, or do you use more than one camera? Because of different angles and cuts, they are beautiful. Why don't you introduce your little twins in your dance videos? How can I be helpful to you rather just been sharing your video from India, as you are doing great work that most of the people don't do for their profile. You are a selfless online tutor. That was quite a few questions, actually. Let's just start off with the take. So it just depends what I'm shooting. A lot of times if I know I'm gonna edit it and make it look really cool and do a lot of editing tricks, then I'll do multiple takes and get different angles. Most of the time, shoot with one camera and do different angles. Or if I have the ability to shoot with 2, then I will do that to save time. As far as my twins goes, I will be involving them more on my channel. I don't know if it will be with dance or more in my vlogs and things like that, but I will be introducing them to you guys more. So definitely you will see the twins more often. So what you could do for me, honestly, just continue to watch the videos, share them. If you think they're helpful, share with other people that you'd feel like will also benefit from it. Very grateful for you just following me and learning from me. So thanks for all the support. I appreciate it. This next question comes from a person that has my same exact name. It says Miran Tech. It seems like he has 2 questions. One says, you are a choreographer, and the answer to that is yes. Second question is, when did you start your channel? I opened my channel a long time ago in 2008. I had uploaded a few videos and that was pretty much it, but I consistently started making dance videos and tutorials on YouTube, April 2016. So I've been super consistent since then. Pretty much that's it, I guess a year and a half. This is from Zankana.07. It says, do you read books? If yes, what kind of books do you read? I don't read books. I listen to audio books. I used to read books when I didn't have the option of audio books, but I'll tell you why I use audio books is because my schedule is extremely busy. To actually sit down and open a book and read it, that means I have to invest the time to just sit down and read it. As far as audiobooks, I could do that while I'm driving. I could do that while I'm working out. And as far as what kind of books I read, most of the books I read, 99%, if not 100%, it's all business books, motivational books, philosophy books. The last book that I've been listening to is called Be Obsessed or Be Average, which is a lot to do with my personality. That book is definitely not for everyone. It's only for the obsessed, I'll let you know that. It's by Grant Cardone. If you wanna check it out, check it out. It might change your life if you are the type of person who likes to work hard and are obsessed and will do anything to accomplish your dreams. Do you still work as a backup dancer? Are you choreographing for some stars? Who are they? I love you, keep going, Miron. You're such an inspiration. Thank you. So do I dance as a backup dancer? That's no. Just no longer interested in doing that. I did that for a very long time as a career. Am I choreographing for any stars? Not at the particular moment. Honestly, I'm strictly focused on doing more of the content that I've been creating on YouTube and creating my own channel where I could provide you guys with all the dance content that you need, whether they're tutorials or dance videos. I'm working with a lot of young talent managing and starting off their careers. So that's something that I'm really passionate about and I want to do more. So it's just a different time in my life and a different vision that I see moving on forward. Will I work with stars in the future? Most definitely. But I will continue to dance and I will continue to create and do a lot more stuff on YouTube and on the web and definitely give you guys some more content to really watch, enjoy, and get value from. We have a question from Aggressive Amon. It says, sir, I want to learn dance. I'm new to the field. I don't know the ABCD of dance. I'm 17 years old and I'm able to learn dance. And how much months can I become a good dancer? So this is actually a funny question because I'm actually working on a project right now that I will be releasing on my YouTube channel probably a month from now. It's gonna be, I know some of you guys have seen my Three Simple Moves videos, which are very basic steps, and it's been very helpful for you. But what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna come up with a playlist, which is kind of like exactly what this question is about. It's literally gonna be the ABCDs of breaking it down from, if you've never even danced before and you have no experience, I'm gonna create a video for you. It's gonna be that basic. It's gonna go from step one all the way to the end where you'll be able to dance fully, doing choreography, moving to music, being able to use your mind differently and being creative and coming up with your own dance steps. So it's gonna be a full playlist for anybody who has ever wanted to dance. I'm gonna constantly come up with new videos every week, breaking it down from head movement to arm movement to feet movement, everything. So I feel like this is going to be a game changer, honestly. So I'm really, really excited to just spread dance and have you guys take your time and be able to learn off of YouTube in the comfort of your own home. So definitely watch out for that. I will be releasing more information regarding that. I will probably start this in the next month, hopefully sooner. So keep watching the channel and you'll definitely see these videos coming up and hopefully I'll help you get through those steps. This comes from Argentinita_26. When you started teaching, did you get certified beforehand or did you start teaching purely from experience on tours as a professional dancer? If you did have to get certified, what field it is? Because here in New Zealand, anything based on their dancer teacher is ballet. No, I did not get certified before I started dancing. In LA, in America, I guess, your resume is kind of your certification of dance in a way. So if you're dancing professionally in the entertainment industry, especially doing tours with different artists and being in music videos and movies, it doesn't get better certified than that. So you don't need any type of certification unless you're working at a school or in some type of environment where you might need a certification. But in the entertainment industry, it's really about your talent and what you could bring to the table and a piece of paper does not determine that. Your actual talent does. So it doesn't really play a big part here. I understand in some other countries it means a lot, but not in America. Thank you for sending all the questions. I did my best to answer as many as I can. I did notice some of the questions were repetitive, so I was trying to make sure I get some of those answers out of the way. If I missed your question, I apologize. I will go back on YouTube and look through some of the questions and maybe type it out and answer it that way. Like I said, this was my first Q&A. I wanted to just get some answers out there for you guys that I felt like, you know, would help you guys to get to know me a little better. Other than that, I will see you guys next time with a brand new video. Leave all your comments in the comment box. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon.